Hi there, I'm John Bond from Riverwinds Consulting, and this is Publishing Defined. Today I'm going to talk about OER, or Open Educational Resources. OER is an umbrella term for freely accessible, openly licensed text, media, and other digital assets that are useful for teaching, learning, assessing, as well as for research purposes. The movement is an outgrowth of the open access, open science, and open education movements. The term OER got started in the late 90s or early 00s and is usually credited to David Wiley or MIT or the William and Flora Hewlett Foundation, who all played roles in launching the valued movement. OER material is usually digital and carries a broad level of openness with ready access with no restrictions on reuse, usually using a Creative Commons license. In fact, many times the material can be personalized to an institution or school. The material comes in the form of student textbooks or workbooks, faculty resources, supplemental content, videos, worksheets, software, or other materials. The digital and open nature of the material means easier revising when errors are found or the content becomes outdated. The obvious benefit is very low or no cost to the students or to the school or institution. The initial focus of the OER movement was on K-12 education, but it quickly expanded to higher education, including highly academic fields. Higher education is a natural place for OER to blossom and succeed as the price of course materials continue to rise. OER faces a few challenges. First, there's no universal open file format. Second, the perception still exists that free means lower quality. Expanding acceptance of open access journal articles may help to change that. Also, efforts such as the Center for Open Education at the University of Michigan to have faculty around the country review and rate the material will help ensure quality and reliability of this content. There's a lot going on in this area. An organization such as OER Commons at oercommons.org is leading the way. They, quote, offer a comprehensive infrastructure for curriculum experts and instructors at all levels to identify high-quality OER and collaborate around the adaptation, evaluation, and use to address the needs of teachers and learners. Major institutions such as MIT, Google, the William and Flora Hewlett Foundation, and many other major foundations and many state and national governments are investing heavily in developing and promoting OER. I look forward to reporting back on OER's headway into higher education, particularly in STEM education, very, very soon. Well, that's it. I've released a new ebook called The Request for Proposal and Publishing, Managing the RFP Process. It's a short focus guide to the essential business tasks that associations or society use to find potential publishing partners. See the link in the notes below for more information on the book or how to purchase it. And hit the like button below if you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel or click on the playlist here to see more videos on OER. And make any comments below or email me with any questions. Thanks so much and take care.